How annoying. And the problem is that every run is gonna take a long time, but the boss is gonna keep saying no. I thought that this was the achievement that was gonna be easy to get, but now I'm not that sure anymore. God damn it. I don't think picking any other character will really change much here. In fact, it probably won't change anything. Okay. I'm definitely not gonna use those spells that break the ground. At least I'm not gonna redeem them. Or, I mean, the ones that break a lot of the ground. There are some that still break the ground that are really not that bad. Didn't you beat her with the gun dealing almost 2k damage? Probably, I don't remember. It was the money gun, right? Yeah, maybe it was because of that. In which case, it's a problem because, you know, I do use the money with this girl. Maybe I should try Shiso, but Shiso is gonna get obliterated. Even if he makes it to the final boss, there's something that I can't forget about, which is the fact that, you know, it's the fact that he cannot revive because obviously you kill Reva. So you're not gonna get revived by Reva. But Tim, I really don't know what to do then. Because it's not working with Saffron. Definitely was not expecting this to be the hard achievement. God damn it. I expected that beating the game with Terra will be way harder than this, but it turns out that this seems like a high enough challenge. Well, hopefully changing the fact that I won't pick the spells that break a lot of the ground, hopefully that changes much, but I don't think it's gonna change much. Okay. I'm a little bit tilted, I gotta say. I'm not gonna lie to your face, I am a little bit tilted. But it's okay. I gotta think that this is the second to last achievement. Which I don't know how much of a consolation prize it is, but you know. I'm really not gonna be able to kill that thing without killing the... No, I definitely will. There you go. It was close. But yeah, something that also is not helping me is how much of a problem the lack of health when I get to the boss is. I just got unlucky with health in the last level. I think that's the issue. I have gotten pretty unlucky. But you know. If I could start the final boss fight with full health, I think I will have a lot more confidence to actually beat it. And I think, considering how much I'm even struggling to defeat the boss, will be pretty interesting to see how much I'm gonna struggle to even survive the loop. But you know, that's not important. As I say before, even if I get killed immediately when I get to the loop, as long as I get the achievement, the loop itself doesn't matter, so yeah. Can hit self? No, screw that. And also screw all of these spells. Can you lob twice or more? Probably, considering that the statistics page tells you like what's your max loop, I will assume that you can do that, yes. Definitely, I'm not gonna try hard, but you know. I know you like Dodonpachi, so maybe you will like doing it in this game. I definitely don't. I mean, I don't like looping, that is. Wait, the map? There is still some time to the bonfire, so... I need more mana recovery. My mana recovery right now is so bad. I need more. I'm not re... Yeah, I know, but you know. Despite you not being re, you still do a lot of masochistic challenges, you know? Oh. That will be a perfectly valid masochistic challenge for sure. Gotcha. Yeah, give me that one. Getting to the bonfire, at least I'm gonna be full health. I'm gonna kill the rabbit, cause probably need to have good luck. So I could do that. I don't really care about the maximum mana, I want recovery. Wow, you know, last time you gave me recovery like 5 times in a row, and now not even once. Really appreciate that. Piece of shit. Pacifist is good. I know. Pacifist is definitely the ending that you want to go for if all you want to do is just beat the game. But yeah. I'm still disappointed that... that I'm struggling so much with Serif. I really shouldn't be struggling with Serif, but I am. Oh yeah, I'm a little bit annoyed by that at the moment. Oh, when you say pacifist is good, you mean pacifist in Toho. No, that's not good. That's anything but good. Actually, you know, there are a lot of spell cards that have some stuff that hit on the other side. And if they actually hit on your side, they will be really dangerous, and I think the spell card that I just picked up is one of them. If I were to fight against Serif, I wouldn't want to switch sides after that. So I probably should delete it once I get to Serif. Because it really feels like it's gonna be very, very dangerous to deal with. Damn it, this fucking cactus. I didn't even see it. I mean, I did see it, but I didn't pay attention. It's okay. I could go for either the bonfire or the shop. Either of those are fine. I still need a lot of mana recovery though. Right now, this speed of recovery is insanely slow, so I need more. I need much more than this. cactus. Gain luck. Yeah, sure. As long as it gives me better weapons, I guess it's fine. I'm gonna go for the bonfire here. I want the guaranteed health instead of just gambling. Oh, I was out to ask, what's even hitting me? And it was the poison that this piece of shit is throwing. No wonder I was getting hit. Yeah, sure, apply fragile and that's it. Damn it. I'm really tilted that I have in my mind the fact that I might get to the final boss only to lose on it. I wasn't feeling that, you know. That uncertainty before, because I thought that Serif wouldn't cost me that much. I mean, it shouldn't. I'm a little bit upset. Yeah, nice dodge. I wish you could fight Serif, but you had every benefit from the characters that you save. Obviously, the issue with that is that here you like, if you want to get to Serif, you have to save no one. There is that. I also think that it might be a pretty good time to think, you know, eventually when I get these two achievements, to think about what game to play afterwards. I mean, obviously not today, but I mean, whatever day I do this, I will need to know. Well, before I say that, I will play the game called Balfaris, and I think it's a good idea, but yeah, it might be a good idea. I don't think I have many other ideas if it's not for that one. Oh yeah, sure, I could play that. I don't know how hard that game is, which kind of scares me. Because it's apparently a challenging game. Is it gonna be as hard as Wings of B? If it's as hard as Wings of B, I think I got lost on the Hong Kong lab. I don't know. That's something that you will have to ask Kyle about. He didn't play that game, so I have no clue. Definitely have no clue. That was a bad idea, using that spell when it was clear that the nurse was there. Oops. Warpath. Oh, this is a cool spell. Though I think it leaves you pretty exposed, but Gabby's on the warpath. What you mean that I'm on the warpath? What does that mean? Honestly, it doesn't seem like it pushes the enemy back as I am attacking, so I think I'm losing on a lot of potential damage. Gotcha. Hailstorm? Yeah, I think I'm gonna take Hailstorm. And maybe start with the enemies frozen might be a good idea too. Probably. Maybe. Someone is on the warp, but they are very angry and getting ready for an argument or a fight. I guess the name makes sense considering that that's what pretty much the character is doing. She's blindly attacking forward instead of having like a strategy or something like that. Oh yeah, I didn't know that was an actual English word. I guess you learn something new every day. I'm going for the shop, so hopefully these assholes don't damage me that badly. You never know. Nice, guy. I don't think glaive is gonna be a good idea. Ah, damn it! I didn't mean to damage the nurse. I mean, of course I didn't. Come on, bro. Alright. 10 shield whenever a tile is broken. I think I'd rather have the money. Don't really care how much mana, but I have a lot of money now, so hopefully I really hope that you give me, you know, recovery. I mean mana recovery. Not that recovery, though I guess I can also heal, sure, why not? There we go, mana regen, this is what I need. Oh, blue blood is also something that is cool. I think I'm fine with that. I killed a nurse again. I'm killing so many nurses. It's insane how many of them I'm murdering. I mean, it's not my fault that they are getting in the way. Alright. At least this boss is not one of the last ones, thankfully. This is a pretty painful boss to deal with. I definitely need that artifact that increases my attack for every 5 spells that I have or something like that. That's definitely something that I need. Oh. That's gonna crush me once. Take better care of the healing wife. I mean, what can I do? They don't move out of the way. And we are in the middle of a fight where bullets are flying around like crazy. Of course I'm gonna kill them. It ain't my fault. But yeah. Okay. Sadly, Reva is gonna be the last boss. And that's gonna be fucked. Reva being the last boss cannot be good news at all. In no world can that be good news. Fuck. I'm getting relatively unlucky, I think, with Reva. Reva, as the last boss, is gonna fuck me up really, really badly. I really hope that she's gonna be gentle. But she's definitely not gonna be gentle, that's the issue. At least the normal enemy seems like they are not gonna be that much of an issue. But yeah, Reva is gonna be a problem for sure. See, right now I will need a nurse. Right now having a nurse will be a pretty good idea. But I guess I kill them all. Oh, well, I could use this for sure. Yeah, I have to go here. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. Damn, the nurse is actually gonna die again. Definitely not taking care of the nurses properly. I mean, well, I don't even know if that's me, the one who killed that nurse. It probably was, but what do you think of Code Bane? That it's pretty expensive, that's what I think. I don't know, I haven't played it or even seen a playthrough of it, but I'm turned off from playing it because it seems to be a little bit expensive. Even if it's not crazily expensive, it's still something that it's a nice game, but the controls feel a bit off, especially on the ice areas. Well, I guess that's something that people usually say about Dark Souls the first time they play, right? That the controls feel off. Probably because they are not crazy as in a hack and a slash. It's expensive and at 60% off. Yeah, that's what I mean. That's the funny thing. Can I hit myself with this? No, okay. Well, if I can't hit myself with this, then sure, give it to me. Oh, this is one of the best artifacts that you can get. In fact, because of this artifact, now I might not be that afraid of the final boss. You get iframes for 0.75 seconds. You get fragile, but it doesn't really matter, honestly, because the benefit is so big that getting fragile really doesn't matter that much at all. So, you know. I will really appreciate you stop giving me max mana and you actually give me mana recovery, for fuck's sake. You're a piece of shit. Alright. Is that how you're gonna do it? Yep, that's how you're gonna do it. I guess I could do this one, even though that's not that good of an artifact. Yeah, iframes. You have blue blood. Blue blood is an insanely good artifact as well. But I think not as good as the one with the iframes. The one with the iframes is just really, really good. But you know, it can only help so much because the bosses are gigantic douchebags. You know, a lot of times doesn't matter that much. It will matter in the final boss fight, but obviously we will have to get there in the first place, which I don't know if it's gonna happen or not, really. I will really love if it happened. Well, I mean, I would really love to beat the... well, not to beat, but to, like, get the fucking loop. That's what I want. Just give me a loop. That's all I need. Did I even dodge one of those? My health is pretty badly right now. What about the Yakuza series? I don't know, they feel a little bit wonky when it comes to the combat, you know? Like, I mean, I don't think they are bad games, but they are just not really attractive to me. Even less so the latest one that was released, that it's a turn-based game. So yeah, I'm definitely not interested that much in Yakuza. But you know, maybe at some point I will eventually try it. But I'm not really thinking that much about it right now. Yeah, I think it's definitely one of those games that I'm gonna play probably once at some point in my life, but probably not anytime soon. Ooh, I almost killed the nurse. But you know, something about the Yakuza series that I will admit that I like is Baka Mitai. That's a pretty good song, I will admit. But you know, that's not even the main focus of the game. this sucks. Okay. Just calm down. Damn it, this asshole is damaging me a lot. Wow, and he actually killed the nurse. How unlucky do I have to be for that to happen? That's absolutely fucked up. I got so insanely unlucky. Well, at least I'm gonna get healing. Some of their games are really cheap right now. I will see. You gotta remind me of this on Discord, because I'm definitely gonna forget about it, because you know, there are so many games that I have to check out that's definitely not gonna be one of those that is gonna pop up if I don't get reminded. As much as I would like healing, I think 2 weapon damage is really good, especially right now. Sadly, what I don't like about this is that I'm gonna be fighting against Reva. So, not having full health is probably gonna be a gigantic handicap. Is this a nurse killing run? Probably. I mean, the problem is, so for example... Okay, right there I didn't kill the nurse. So, that's not my fault that the nurse died there. I'm not gonna take responsibility for that one. I don't like any of those. Okay, Reva. It's probably gonna be as hard as the final boss. Well, not that hard, but I mean, it's gonna be tough for sure. Well, for an attack like this, the artifact about the iframes is insanely good. because those things hit you continuously. You definitely do not want to get hit multiple times in less than, you know, in a pretty short time period. Definitely don't want that. Damn, I have such a big shield right now. Sadly, I have to shuffle soon enough, so I'm gonna lose a little bit of it. I don't think I'm gonna lose that much. Something that I also seen is that it seems that when you have more... when you have more spells, the shuffle takes longer, which is something that I didn't knew. I didn't know, I mean. Alright. Yeah, shoes, hold on. Fuck you. It's your fault you didn't clear the enemies fast enough. God damn it. I don't think I want Blessing of the Susanna, really. I'd rather have the Diamond Ring. Oh, and the poison here. Wait, fire two shots diagonally? Both of these are really good. I think I'd rather have this, but the problem is that this will only be useful in a very specific angle. Well, this is way... No, I think I'm gonna get the poison one. Because it shouldn't be that hard to hit the final boss. And if I'm really far away, it's not like it's gonna be any easier. Uh-oh. Gotcha, damn, and the nurse survives somehow. Blessing of the Amaterasu is better. Damn, look at this shit. Sadly, this spell is so hard to hit. So I don't think I'm gonna get it. It's a really good spell, but it's so hard to hit. Frost to a random enemy on Trinity Cast. No, I'd rather have Matt's mana. And definitely this way. Oh, this gigantic tower. This tower is really dangerous. Probably the most dangerous normal enemy in the game. Well, I don't know if it's the most dangerous, but definitely one of the most dangerous. The damage that it deals is insane. And it's all counter-attack damage, so it's not like it's not gonna do it. Like, it's gonna do it if you want to kill him, and you obviously want to. Okay. And you have those assholes that fill the screen with a gigantic laser. Okay. Cataclysm, no, but I could probably have barrier. It's a consume type, really. Okay, at least... Okay, I don't want to shins it, so I'm not gonna say anything. But probably I already shins it just for thinking about it. Damn it. Okay, hopefully I don't. Okay, I didn't shins it yet, though there is still room for shinsing. But basically, all I'm gonna say is that I don't have to use the bonfire. That's really good. Oh, I'm definitely gonna use this one, yeah. So I can go to the shop and spend all my money here. Damn, mana region, good shit. Damn, now you're giving me the mana region. I like that. Add a kunai to your deck for every spell you consume this battle. So in theory, this is a good spell, but I don't like kunais. Even if kunais don't waste any mana and they can be cast instantly, I don't know how good, like how much I can hit them. Well, I guess if I don't like the kunais, I'm just gonna shuffle. Maybe that was a mistake. Oh shit, give me this one too. I need miracles here, yes. Damn, all this mana region is insane. When you save a hostage, I don't think that's gonna be possible, no. Oh shit, I restock and it doesn't give me any more artifacts. That's interesting. Was not expecting that, but alright. I guess you can give me an upgrade as well. What should I upgrade? I definitely should get rid of Firestorm because this is gonna end up fucking me up eventually. So I'm gonna get rid of that one. And what should I upgrade here? Which one of these should I even upgrade? Coldstone? Or maybe the Ramshed that is already upgraded, so... I guess I'm... Yeah, sure, whatever. Upgrade this one. Heal, but it consumes. I don't want that. Double cast, oh, definitely this one. It costs more mana, but I have so much mana recovery that it shouldn't be a problem. Okay. So the problem, these two enemies. Damn, that's fucked up, dude. These two enemies against me. At the same time. Alright, I got it. So I'm full health. So the theory says... And obviously that's just the theory. But the theory definitely says that I should be able to survive. Like, this is very different from all of the other attempts. I'm full health right now. So it should work. But I don't know. I don't want to underestimate Serif. This is definitely a boss that you don't want to underestimate at all. Really, really bad idea. Oh, that was close. Really wonder if all of the kunais that I'm getting are gonna be worth it. I hope they are, but I don't know. I guess I have a lot of shield spells, but... And this fucking attack... I hate that attack so much. I also, you know, I don't want to shint it, but she hasn't changed side yet. Oh... That's good, though at the same time she's also keeping me away quite a lot. Okay. Now you switch sides. See, that's why I didn't... It was a bad idea to shins it. It's okay. This is still not a bad fight. I still have the chance to not get fucked. Nice attack. Also, what happened with that kunai spell? Where are my kunais? Did I get screwed over? Or maybe I didn't read the spell properly? Oh, well, there are my kunais. I thought I would get much more than that. Wasn't that for every spell that I use? Or maybe it was for each spell that I consume? Which is different than using in this game. So maybe it was that. Get on. Okay, so here I have to do nothing. You might be trying a bit too hard. Okay, so here maybe I will make better choices. I'm not sure about that. And I got the achievement, there it is, return to the past. So in theory what happens here is, the game goes back to the first level, but everything is way harder. As you can see by these enemies having so much health, despite being the first enemies. I found a mirror clone, I'm probably going to buy it. How is it called? Actually, I think I know how it's called. If it's the one I think it is. I wonder if it is. Wish? Yeah, I think it's the one that has like a wheel to pick the actions. Like there is a wheel in the UI and you pick it, each action like that. Is that the one? Because if that's the one, that's a good choice. I was about to buy it in a previous sale, but I was like, nah, bro. I have to stop thinking with my dick so much. Doesn't look like it. Okay, so maybe it's another one. Or maybe you're just blind. I mean, both can happen. Also, speaking of being blind, I wanna remind you that it doesn't matter what happens now. Like, I already looped this run, so basically whatever happens after this is irrelevant because I already got the achievement that I was looking for. But I'm still gonna keep going to see... Wait, what does it say? 1 × 8, 2? Oh, I guess the 1 means the loop. That I'm in loop 1 or some shit like that. It's not like I played it. Yeah, but I mean, you kinda have to know what you are buying, right? Well, it wouldn't surprise me if you didn't, but... I mean... Come on, bro. Gotcha. Can't carry any more artifacts? What you mean I can't carry any more artifacts? Who says that? I can carry whatever artifacts I want. You got a problem with that? Damn, so I reached the limit of artifacts. That's pretty funny. So that basically means that... there is a limit for artifacts. I thought that it basically was infinite, but... It does seem like the spells that you can get are infinite. Damn, that's pretty cool that I reached the limit of artifacts. You are too OP? Yeah, I'm pretty OP apparently. So OP that I got the limit. The limit. I don't like any of this. In fact, I probably should change the Phalanats. The Phalanats modifier and change it to something like, I don't know, Anima. Not sure how good it is, but I think I pretty much have all of the shield spells that I would want to have. I don't think there are many more that are missing, and even if there are more that are missing, I can probably get them eventually. I don't like Shiso being the first boss. Damn, magic is overrated, this guy is saying. What a heretic. So, sorry. Damn it. This is my current plan. I'm gonna try to go for a pacifist loop here and see if I can win, though I don't think that that's gonna happen, but I'm not gonna go for another loop, that's for sure. It's already gonna be a pretty off chance that I win here, even going for the pacifist, so yeah. Let's not forget that every boss is gonna start at 5. So this is like having the second to last health pass modifier. You know. Nice, get fucked. In fact, I'm already about to die once. And this is just the first boss. So that's even in the off chance that I even get to the final boss, which... I don't really think it's gonna happen, even though it is certainly a possibility. Chances of it happening are pretty... Oh, I'm dead. Oh, I'm not dead. Somehow. 15. That was a lot of damage. Alright. But I'm gonna spare you this time, alright? Because I'm a kind soul. That should be an achievement. What? Beating the game after the loop? Fuck you. That definitely should not be an achievement. You're out of your mind. You know how hard that is? You're absolutely out of your mind. Wow, what a fucking asshole. He actually woke up this... the little monster. Sunder. Life Sword. Jeez. Strike all enemies that have frost and apply one fragile. I would rather have this one, sadly. Oh, no, never mind. Lose max HP, fuck that. Even if this is a double cast, so I will literally be doing 800 points of damage, which is a lot. But you have to be out of your mind if you want me to lose 30 max HP every time I do this. I know that I'm Saffron and I have a lot of HP to spare, but that's just crazy. I'd rather have that, this one. We gotta ask the devs to update the game and add that achievement just so Gabby doesn't get the 100%. Well, technically, like, if you want to be very specific, even getting all the achievements still wouldn't really mean 100%, because you can unlock loadouts for characters by beating the world boss with the character that you want to unlock the loadout with, which is something that I haven't done for every character. Even the characters that I already beat the game with, they don't have their secondary loadout. So, yeah. Are you gonna ask them to put that as an achievement too? Don't think people are gonna be pretty happy about that. That kinda happened to you with Terraria. What? Which thing? Damn, this chest is healing on top of having a shit ton of health. That's fucked up. Can't carry any more artifacts. So I guess destroying... wow, another tsunami. So, by picking this tsunami up, does that mean that I'm gonna have two tsunamis? Or am I gonna just have a better version of the tsunami I... So, this is the previous tsunami. Oh, so I have two tsunamis. That's fucked up. They added more achievement as I was about 200%. That's fucked up. Yeah, more achievements in the last update. Well, hopefully these people don't do it. Or, you know, I mean, if they do it, it will give me an excuse to play this game more. Because I know that there is a lot of you that will prefer to see other games. Like, and it's understandable considering how long I've been playing this for. But, you know, yeah. Should I get this soul link? Yeah, sure, whatever. So yeah, I know, you want me to play a different game, but that's gonna have, Jesus Christ, 14k. And I cannot buy any artifact because of that. Well, I can at least buy spells, I guess. I don't know which one. Well, maybe using prophecy now that I'm not gonna fight Seraph is not a bad idea. Warp race? I think I'd rather have Orbital Beam there. I don't like that. Monument. Summons a monument that falls. No, I don't like the way that sounds. I'm definitely getting Shine. Sustain. Gain 1 Trinity. If Trinity is full, gain Shield equal to damage of the spell in the other slot. Seems like a pain in the ass. 14k, that's a thick shopkeeper. Yeah. That's a shopkeeper that you don't wanna piss off. That's for sure. And speaking of fig, this is something that I already said, but I'm gonna say again, because I have no shame. But the characters in this game are really well designed, to the point where, you know, I wouldn't mind seeing fan art of them if you catch my drift. But you know, they are pretty well done. All of them. Maybe the one that looks like a fucking idiot will be Shiso, but he has a cowboy outfit that at least looks cool. But the default, I personally feel that the default outfit that Shiso has makes him look like a fucking idiot. That artifact that makes the enemies go slower when they are frozen is really good. You really notice the difference a lot. So you have a lot of spell power. Why do you have so much spell power? What is the reason for that? Oh, someone is gonna get hit by a prophecy. Or maybe not, because... oh, yeah, you got hit. You're fine, because I'm gonna spare your life. Some of them are easy in the eyes. Western art style is in my favorite. Well, that's what I like so much about this game. Like, this is Western art that looks good. And it's something that it's pretty hard to see, like, nowadays. Like, usually a lot of artists go for really... how should I say this? Like, they go for a particular style, and by style I mean that they try to make the character look as inhuman as possible. As you can see with the multiple Cartoon Network shows that have released from 2000, well, I guess mid-2000 onwards, which basically they are... I mean, the content of the show can be pretty good. I don't deny that, but they are so fucking ugly. This game, and I praise it because of that, it's one game that does Western art right. Like, I mean, I don't even think that the concept of Western art is a good one, because... that's a pretty broad term that I don't think it encompasses a lot of things at all. Like, it's too broad. But, you know, I mean, if you want to say, like, non-Japanese art, to make it more clear, this is one of the best that you can probably see. And what I like about it is that it's not just non-Japanese art trying to copy the Japanese anime aesthetic. This is its own art style, and it looks good, which, as I mentioned multiple times, is something that most non-Japanese artists can do for some reason. Or if they do, it's because they copy Japanese style. So that's why I feel that this game has such amazing art. Probably one of the few that has that. This is big western pretty much. I know. Because, you know, when I think to myself to western art that looks good, the first thing that might come to my mind is Avatar, The Last Airbender. But what's the problem with that? That's art that it's insanely similar to Japanese art style. In fact, I mean, if you didn't know where the show came from, you will call it an anime, probably. But that's what I like about this game. It looks like its own thing, and it looks good. Really, really wish more artists were like this. I don't even know who is the artist, but whoever is the artist, kudos to them. I really wonder what kind of other works they have. Not the Flambers. Well, I mean, you can see clearly the shopkeeper there. That doesn't look like an anime-style character, and it looks awesome still. Like, it looks awesome. And it's, you know, it's its own style. So, I feel that more artists should be inspired by this artist. Well, art. Whoever this artist is, I don't even know who the artist is, but probably should watch the credits. I don't really like watching credits. I mean, I like, you know, just letting them pass, but I already let them pass on my first two runs. There was like a whole shitstorm over people calling Avatar anime. Yeah, that happens every time, but I mean, it really depends. You know, I mean, it's the usual argument of people that say that anything that looks like a Japanese animation is anime. There are other people that say that anime only comes from Japan, and there are people that, well, will call everything an anime, as long as it's animated. The thing is, and the fucked up thing about it is that see, here's the thing. Kati Sarin Sing Gasane. Well, that's a pretty specific name, so I definitely should find something there. Thanks a lot, Sirius. How is it going? Thanks. I will try to... Well, I mean, I will probably have to write it down, because I'm definitely not gonna remember. But yeah. Thanks. That's really nice of you. But yeah, what was I about to say about... about anime. You know, the thing is, as multiple people point out, the Japanese call anime to anything that is animated. So by that concept, you know, you could give the argument that calling everything an anime would be fitting. But then, if that's the case, what's the purpose of the word animation, which is what anime comes from anyways? So, yeah, I mean, that's a debate that is never gonna settle down. Like, some people, as I said, are gonna call anime only things made in Japan. Other people will call anime anything that is similar to Japan. And then some people are gonna call anime anything that is an animation. So, you know, the thing is, it doesn't really matter. Because it especially doesn't matter with this game, because as I say, this is its own art style. This is something that that it's just non-comparable to anything, I think. Or at least, I mean, it's not like I'm an expert when it comes to art styles, but I never seen an art style like this one before. And I'm not talking about the pixel art, mind you, because, yeah, the pixel art is pretty common, but... I mean, the characters there, but I'm talking about the portraits, which is pretty well done. Pretty decently, I found that off the Eden website. I forgot she gets like this at high boss levels. Yeah, this is the second loop, so every boss is in a really high tier. I mean, this is level 6 after all, so, you know, definitely quite a lot, but it's alright. I mean, the achievement that I wanted to get, I already got it. So I'm just doing this to see how long I can last. What if Western style work is made in Japan? Yeah, I mean, there is a video that discusses that basically say what's an anime, and then it basically comes to the conclusion that it's such a broad definition that it's probably better to just call, you know, you just call animation, and if you have an art style that is not an animation but it's similar to, you know, the usual Japanese quote-unquote anime art style, then just call it Japanese art style or something like that. They are all mad you killed them last time. Yeah, they are definitely not happy about what happened last time, that's for sure. But I mean, I definitely don't blame them. I murdered them all in cold blood. Now, I really wonder about Terrible here, because in theory, as far as I know, I might be wrong, but I think the final bosses don't scale with tiers. So, you know, in theory, I don't think it should be that big of a deal, right? Will be pretty tilted if I got killed. Yeah, I know. Well, that's where vengeful spirit legends come from. Obviously, come from people that are insanely tilted that they got killed, and I will be tilted too. I think Seraph did, I remember she did. Yeah, I'm definitely not fighting Seraph, that's for sure. Definitely not, because I'm gonna get obliterated. And again, even if I don't really care about the outcome of this run, I will prefer to win the run, if it's possible. And the best way to do that is by going for a pacifist run. That's what I'm trying to do. I don't like any of this. There is still, by the way, if anyone is curious, there is one achievement left that I still haven't gotten. And at this point, judging by the hour, I will have to do it tomorrow probably. But the achievement of beating the game with all characters is literally the last achievement that I haven't gotten. And it's basically about beating the game with Terra, which is the last character that I couldn't beat the game with. I have beaten the game with every single character, except for Terra. I just can't beat the game with Terra. I don't know, I'm not an expert of this game, but I think that Terra as a, like, her playstyle is absolute trash. It's sad because she has a really good design, but you know, I think that her playstyle is no good. Or as Kiryu will say, it's dame dane. Right. Is that what it says? I have ambush with 400 damage and consume. What can you give me? I don't think there are many spells that you give me that I don't already have. In fact, mistletoe, I already have it. But I have like an upgraded version. We'll probably get this one. Nah. Unleash. Okay, I'm definitely getting this one. Excuse me? I think you like Terra, right? Yeah, that's why I say this is coming from a complete noob perspective. So, you know, don't take what I say too seriously, because, you know, I'm not an expert at this game, or not even close. But I'm just saying that from my novice experience, Terra's playstyle is just bad. But, you know, it's alright. I'm talking, by the way, about the default loadout, not the second one. I mean, I wish I could know about the second one, but sadly, in order to do that, I will have to beat the game with her first, which is not happening. So that's my problem. You play her a lot. She can be difficult to work with. I definitely don't like her. I also don't like Violet or Violet or whatever the hell you pronounce her name. I don't like that character either. Basically, Violet and Terra are the two characters that I just can't find a specific redeeming quality. Again, in my beginner mind. I'm not trying to talk as an expert, but as a beginner. And as a beginner, none of those two characters have given me anything good. Though at least I was able to beat the game with Violet, even if it was really clutch, but it happened at least. In fact, not only it happened, but I also beat the wall. So, you know. I don't think that's something that I can do with Terra. You know, I haven't got around to trying Violet, but most of my clears are with Terra. Violet is a character that is interesting, but as I always say, and she's like pretty much most of the characters in the game, I feel that it's a character that it requires too much effort for too little reward. You could say that it's not such a bad character because you can get shield, trinity, and mana recovery every time you want, but at the same time, it's highly complex the way you do it, so I don't think it's worth the effort for Violet, but I mean, she works. I could make her work somehow. In reality, I probably got really lucky, but it's alright. Uh-oh. Getting damage a lot. Should be dead. Damn, the missile stopped in time. Earth Shatter Terra sucks against the wall. What's her shatter? Is that the default loadout or is that the alternative? Fight yourself instead? Well, I try fighting myself, but I lost. That's why I'm trying to attempt the wall. Well, I mean, not now, but whenever I try it. I couldn't beat against Terrible. Loadout 1, I see. Yeah, as I say, I couldn't beat Terrible with Loadout 1. And that's why, well, I tried getting to the wall. The thing is, I didn't even try the wall, because when I tried getting to the wall, I die before that. A normal boss killed me. I don't even remember who killed me. It was probably either Reva or Saffron, because those two bosses are out of their minds. But yeah. Is she like subterranean animus in Marisa B? What, Violet? I'm not sure if you can say that it will be an equivalent of that. Nah. If anything, if you want to compare someone to subterranean animus Marisa B, it will be probably Reva. I mean, not in the sense that her strength is mobility as Marisa B, but more as in, you know, like more as in, damn it, what was I about to say? Like that it's still useful and not that hard to use. So I will compare Reva to Marisa B of that game. Maybe. Or maybe the engineering girl, Hazel. That might be a good equivalence too. Both of those characters are useful in their own right, even if they are not really the strongest ones. So yeah, I will say that. Again, give me, oh wait. Damn. With that much damage nerf? And fuck you. And your damage nerf. Lich. No, honestly, I don't like any of it. What is that emote? Snacking? Wait. Oh, I was... I was gonna say, did someone sub? Oops. Sorry, Yannick, my memory is pretty bad. Hey, Clone Cat, how is it going? I'm here doing a pretty crazy run. In the second loop of the game, almost feeling like a Dodonpachi run. Earthshatter Terra needs mana reach and she's supposed to get it by breaking tiles. Yeah, but it's pretty hard to be able to do that and at the same time focus on the enemy. That's my problem. Saffron is kinda nuts now. She used to be derp. Are you talking about the boss or are you talking about the playable character? Because I heard that the boss got reward. Like the boss is pretty different from what it was before. The boss, yeah. Yeah, I mean, Saffron is probably the hardest normal boss in the game right now. Reva is pretty close though. Reva is pretty fucked up. But I think that Saffron is the hardest one. Again, in my noob experience. Did you already beat it with the character you hate? No, I actually didn't. In fact, we were talking about that just yet. Oh yeah, sadly I didn't do that. How many of these do you have? Oh, I couldn't dodge that, goddamn it. And that deals so much damage. It's alright, I have more shield where that came from. All still die to Reva more though, and to Slicey sometimes. Yeah, maybe. I just personally find Saffron to be a pretty big pain in the ass, though. I think Reva here wants to prove me wrong. Damn, I think that Reva is gonna prove me wrong right now. Damn, this is gonna be pretty interesting. Do you really want to prove me wrong that much, Reva? Come on. This is a pretty long run. Are you gonna make it go to the dumpster? Do you really want that, Reva? Well, you probably would want that, don't you? God damn it. Why you gotta be like this? Aren't you supposed to be a kind knight? I don't think you're being pretty kind right now, Miss Reva. Definitely don't think... Damn. The iframe artifact is saving my ass right now. I would have died at least 3 times if it wasn't for it. Jesus. At least I have one more revive. So there is that. Will be worse with one more revive. Damn it. Okay. That's gonna be one revive. And obviously I don't have the Reva revive because I'm fighting her right now. This girl is out of her mind. Wow, she got killed? What? I think I got a miracle, like literally. I got the artifact that is a miracle that shoots a lightning to the enemy that you're shooting. Good shit, I got really lucky. So, sadly here, I only have one more revive, which is obviously gonna be Reva. Yeah, that was fucked up. That was really fucked up. So I get your point, Sirius. I definitely get your point. Reva can be really fucked up. Thankfully, we're not gonna fight Saffron in this run for obvious reasons, but you know. I'm also a little bit concerned about fighting Hazel right now. I think that fighting Hazel at this point is gonna be really, really bad. I also have a feeling... You know that there is an artifact that increases your damage for every spell that you have? So I feel that I should make room for that. Sadly, I don't have any remove, so I will have to go for the shopkeeper. The shopkeeper is right there. It's something that I didn't know that you could do. At first I thought that artifacts were something that you couldn't remove no matter what, but you actually can. She scales really high. Hazel can be a surprise. Yeah, I can imagine that being the case. I can imagine that being a problem. I also wonder how long I've been in this run so far. It's definitely been more than an hour and a half at this point. But damn. It's really been a lot. That's for sure. There is a limit. A limit for what? A limit for... for the artifacts. Yeah, there is a limit for the artifacts. Yeah, that is indeed the case. I wonder... So, here is the thing. Yeah. There is something that counts as an artifact, which is healing. So, what happens if I delete the healing artifact? Am I gonna get damage? Remove some of those medkits. Okay, so you can actually remove them without getting fucked. Okay, that's what I'm gonna do then. So... I don't think so. Well, we're about to find out. No, you actually don't get damage. Okay, so I can get one more, and I really want the one that I get to be the one that it increases my damage, but I have to get really lucky if I want that one. Like, really, really lucky. I don't think I'm gonna get it. Sarah Cannon would have been really useful if it wasn't for the fact that I used so much money already. So, no. I think I'm not gonna get it. Yeah, Sarah Cannon. That was pretty fucked up. Yeah, but it's not worth using Sarah Cannon when I'm wasting all of my money with this shit. Damn it, I think I just wasted all my money refreshing the stuff just to get nothing. It's okay. But it's alright, we don't need the Sarah Cannon after all. Don't worry about it, we can win this without the Sarah Cannon. In fact, I'm pretty sure that we're not gonna have too much trouble winning, right? In the only problem is gonna be this boss that it's gonna come right here, but I still have hope that I can fuck her up. Well, I can still get an artifact as a reward, so... Wait, this is not even the last boss. There is still one more boss. Well, that's fucked up. I thought that this was the last boss before the final boss. Okay, that's really fucked up. That was a pretty important miscalculation. Alright, it's okay, don't worry about it. Everything is under control. We don't need to panic. For some reason, they don't recognize the turrets as enemies. So that... Ah, fuck you. This attack is so fucked up. And you barely can see when it happens in the first place. Uh-oh. To get out of here. I got really lucky that I got the machine gun right there. Wow, she... How many times did you refresh that spot? That's fucked up, if you ask me. Oh, that was a wasted potion. Yeah, Slicey 8 is... Wait, no, but we are ready for... we are ready for Celicy, right? That shouldn't be a problem. I think it's another one, the last boss, right? I don't remember who it was, though. That's the issue. Maybe it was Celicy, as you say, but I'm really not sure. Damn, the game is dying with the amount of shit that is going on screen. Good shit. The game is absolutely dying. There you go. It's Violet 8. That can be a problem too. Oh, it is. Well, this fight can also be really, really hard. So I hope it's not. But the chance of it being an insane pain in the ass... the potential is definitely there. That's the issue. But hopefully I can deal with it. The game is dying or the FX? I mean, if the FX was dying, you could basically notice the stream dying. But it's definitely not the stream. So yeah. I don't think it's the FX, personally. That was a lot of damage. Jesus Christ, dude. Team will better apply frost to all enemies once per second for 6 seconds. Yeah, sure, why not? I'm getting pretty buff spells. That's because my luck is in 162. So it is to be expected. And this guy got fucked by the swords. Oh, yeah, definitely gonna get this one. Wait, what you... No. What you mean by I can't carry any more artifacts? Oh, because I'm stupid and I got the max mana artifact. Oops. My bad. Well, it's alright. I don't need any more artifacts. I don't need... them artifacts. They are absolutely unnecessary. I mean, I have so much cheap shit that the artifacts are really the least of my problems. So you know. Okay. I wonder if you can kill the bosses that you save when they come to aid you, because in theory you can damage them. So shouldn't it be also possible to kill them? Will be pretty funny. I mean, pretty fucked up though, but you know. Uh-oh. Wait, what if the missile falls? No, it's not gonna fall. Not in time, at least. Sadly, I don't have any delete thing to use, so it's okay. It's alright, we don't need them artifacts. So Violet has 12k points of health, just like that, no fucks given. Absolutely zero fucks given. So this is the attack that is fucked up. Along with the one where she summons like radios. Well, they are not radios, they are like stereos or whatever you call them. Yeah, when she combines both attacks, it becomes really hard. So this can become a real problem. This can definitely become a real problem. I'm really upset that that sword special doesn't count structures as enemies. Structures are enemies, goddammit. Why don't you count them as such? They are the definition of an enemy. I mean, sure, they can think by themselves, but like, come on. Oh, that's pretty fast. Damn, she's gonna make me go pretty fast right now. Jeez. At least she has less health now, but she's still not close to death. Or at least not as close as I would like. I still have one more revive though, let's not forget that, but I will prefer to not use it for this fight if it's possible. Get hit by all of the fucking kunais. Even if she's about to go down, I might go down first. No, she went down first. Good shit. Whew. So now comes the actual final boss, but the problem is she gonna scale, or is she gonna be as easy as the first loop? Oh shit, she actually scales. Well, she scales in health. I'm pretty sure there is no more difficulty on the attacks, but that health is absolutely ridiculous. That's just absolutely ridiculous. I don't know if I can win, honestly. That's a shit ton of health. Yeah, there is a very big probability of dying. This is insane. This is absolutely insane. At the very least, I have a lot of shield for now, obviously. For now. And that structure that apparently heals me if nobody destroys it. It's never gonna work, because everyone here is absolutely insane. I don't like that I'm running out of shield. Definitely don't like that. Still nowhere near close to dying. In fact, she doesn't even have the amount of health that she has at the beginning of the normal fight. Okay, that's fine. This is still pretty possible. You just need to keep it cool, even though it's definitely pretty hard to do. Damn it, actually. Are you kidding me? Those two hit me. That's fucked up. I need shield right now, and I'm not getting it. I'm not getting any shield. I don't like it. Well, thankfully I have the ring that gradually gives me shield, but I need more. Much more than that. Uh-oh. Probably was a bad idea to root her there, but... Okay, this is where she starts doing crazy shit that is pretty hard to dodge, so... Okay, finally some shield. I don't know how long it's gonna last. Damn. This shit is dying. Look at this. The game is absolutely dying. And my dodging also died with the game. Jesus Christ. Well, it's no wonder the game is dying with the amount of shit that is going on, but Jesus Christ. It costed me that dodge, and it might cost me the run, in fact. We'll be pretty pissed off if that was the case, but it's looking like that's gonna be the case. Nice! Jesus Christ, that was such... That was so nerve-wracking. Even the computer died in the middle of the run. Is the stream still up, even? Because that seemed like a pretty severe frame drop that in fact costed me quite... I mean, it costed me one life. So, jeez. We are live? Alright. Man. That was a two-loop run. Well, a one-loop, I guess, but... What a run, dude. I wasn't expecting to win at the end there, especially after that insane frame drop, but... Seems that we clutch it out. Actually, the poison helped me a lot. The poison is the one that finished terrible off. Ishi, thanks. I just read that KFC announced a console. Damn. What? KFC announced a console. Oh, look, there is the artist. A serious says, Kati Sarin Singasane. Alright, I gotta remember that. That I'm probably not gonna remember, but it's okay, don't worry about it. So, that's pretty interesting. We basically murder everyone at the beginning, and then we came back in time and we spared everyone. That's pretty funny. Pretty, you know... It's a life lesson that people can change, you know, or something like that. How long was this run? It was more than an hour and a half for sure, but how much? An hour and 36 minutes. Damn, how many people did I kill? 201 kills? Well, that was quite a lot. But damn. And I didn't unlock anything. I mean, other than the achievement that I already mentioned, but... Sheesh.